7 sin square theta, okay. Suppose you are given anywhere 7 sin square theta plus 3 cos square theta is equal to 4. This is given, okay. And prove that, and you are told to prove that, cot theta plus minus root 3. Okay, this math is given. Okay, so what is cot theta? You know what is cot theta? Cot theta is what? Cosine by sine, right? Cosine by sine. So what should we do? We know cot theta equals to cosine theta by sine theta, right? We know this, right? So what is our first duty? You know, we have to divide all by sine square theta. Okay, let's divide. Write down 7 sine square theta by sine square theta. Okay, then it is written 3 cos square theta by sine square theta. I am going to divide all the terms of both the sides by sine square theta is equal to 4 sine square theta. Dividing both the sides by sine square theta, right? Okay. Here we are getting, you see, only 7. Okay. Here we are getting 3 cot square theta, cos square by sine square equals to cot square. Here we are getting 4 by sine square theta. What is meant by this? 4 by sine square theta. What is meant by this? It is 1 by sine square theta into 4. Right? So we know 1 by sine theta is equal to cosec theta. So 1 by sine square theta will be cosec square theta. Cosec square theta. And this 4 has been kept as it is. I think you have got it. Now, write down 7 plus 3 cot square theta is equal to, it is 4. Cosec square theta equals to what? 1 plus cot square theta, this is the formula. And you see, we are going to find cot theta, right? So we have converted cosec square theta through cot square theta with the help of trigonometric identity. Now we get 7 plus 3 cot square theta is equal to 4 plus 4 cot square theta. Right? After this, we can write down, you see, 7 minus 4 equals to what? Write down. We can write down here 7 minus 4. Okay, is it is equal to 4 cot square theta minus 3 cot square theta. Can you write? Is it okay? Now, from here we can write down cot square theta is equal to 3. Therefore, by square rooting, we can get cot theta equals to plus minus root over 3. Okay. Please copy this math. We are going to exercise 13. We can do some math from exercise 13. Okay. Exercise 13. Here, let's do question number 15 of exercise 13. All of you take out book. Exercise 13. Take out book. Question number 15. Exercise 13, right? Okay. Question number 15. Three spherical balls of glass, okay, of ready 6 cm, 8 cm, and R cm. Actually, what is this here? You see, it is exercise 13. Suppose three balls, that means here it is a spherical ball. Though I have drawn a two-dimensional figure, it is a ball. Another ball. Okay. Now another ball. Three balls. Okay. Is it? Now you see. Suppose its radius is 6 cm. Its radius is 8 cm. And its radius is, suppose its radius is R centimeter. Okay. Now these three balls will be melted. Okay, very good. Suppose they will be melted, that means heat. Okay. They will be melted, right? And a new solid sphere of 9 cm is to be formed. 9 cm. That means volume of this ball volume of this ball and this ball is equal to volume of this ball. Here we have to find the value of R. The question is R equals to what? Dear students, you see in this question that is given in your book, okay, sometimes in the previous version its radius is 9 centimeter was not given, but you may have the correction. Okay, the new ball, it is the new ball, new spherical ball having radius 9 centimeter. It's okay. Now you see what is its volume. Its volume is, you see, the volume of first ball is 4 by 3 pi a cube. This is the formula, 4 by 3 pi a cube, right? 4 by 3 pi a cube. Then second ball, 4 by 3 pi 8 cube. Okay? Third ball, 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, we have got the sum of the volumes of first three balls. Okay, we have got the sum of the volumes of first three balls. Okay, now you see is equal to the volume of the new ball. What is the volume of the new ball? 4 by 3, 4 by 3 pi 9 cube. What is the formula to find out the volume of a spherical ball? The formula is, you must know, formula is 4 by 3 pi a cube, where a is the radius of the sphere. In this ball, radius is 6 centimeter. Here radius is 8 centimeter. Here radius is r centimeter. Here radius is 9 centimeter. That is, if we melt all these three balls, okay, the molten part will be used here to find or to form a new spherical ball. It's okay. Now you see everywhere in this equation we are getting 4 by 3 pi. 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 Right? Now we can divide both the sides by 4 by 3 pi. Okay? Then we will be left with, you see, we will be left with here 6 cube. Here 8 cube, here r cube, okay, and here it is 9 cube. That is, r cube is equal to 9 cube minus 6 cube minus 8 cube. That means r cube equals to 9 cube equals to what? Can you calculate it, please? 9 cube equals to 729 216 512. That is, we are getting r cube equals to 1. R cube equals to 1, that means we get here r equals to 1. I have seen too many students writing its answer is 1 centimeter. Actually not that. It is told in this question, it is told to find the value of R. It is not told to determine the radius of the third sphere. It is not told to determine the radius. But it is told to find the value of R. So we have to find the value of R here. You see, r equals to 1. Write down, therefore, value of r is 1. Don't write down here centimeter. Okay? Do you have any question? Any question from your side? Okay, not a matter. Now you see another math. Question number 17. Okay, please try to understand. Question number 17. Pay attention. Important math to be given in the examination. Question number 17. Here it is told a solid sphere of radius 4 cm. Okay. A solid sphere of radius 4 cm is melted. Okay, that's good. You see what I am going to show. A solid sphere. It is a solid sphere. Solid sphere means what? It is filled in, right? A solid sphere, right? Okay. And it is given that its radius, it is the center. So its radius, this is the radius. And it is given in the question that it is 4 cm. It is 4 cm. 4 cm. I am writing here radius equals to 4 cm. Okay? That's good. It is a solid sphere. Okay, we start. Now, can we find, therefore, the volume of the solid sphere is equal to what I told you, 4 by 3 pi a cube cubic centimeter. Okay, what is the formula to find the volume of a sphere? 4 by 3 pi a cube, right? Okay, now it is told in the question that it will be melted. That means it will be melted, okay? And the molten part will be used to form a hollow sphere. What is meant by this? Okay, you try to understand. The molten part now will be used to form a hollow sphere. Suppose it is now a hollow sphere. You write down. It is a hollow sphere. Okay. Then that means like this, it is a hollow sphere. Okay, it is told in the question it has a radius, outer radius of the hollow sphere. Outer radius of the hollow sphere is given as by 5 cm. It is what? The measurement of this is as by 5 cm. So, okay, let's write down it is 5 cm. It is 5 cm. Please try to understand what I have written here. The outer radius of the hollow sphere is given in the question as by 5 cm. Write down here, outer radius of the hollow sphere is equal to 5 cm, right? So what is outer volume? therefore outer volume will be equal to, what is the formula? As usual formula, 4 by 3 pi a cube cubic centimeter. Now you see there is a thickness in this question. So let's the thickness, suppose it is the thickness, let thickness of the hollow sphere be x centimeter. Let the thickness of the hollow sphere be x centimeter. Here the thickness means, you see, please try to understand, this part is iron, okay, this part is iron, please try to understand. This part is iron, okay. So it has a thickness, the thickness of iron, right? In this question, you have to find the thickness of this sphere, right? Write down, let the thickness be x centimeter. Okay. So it is actually outer radius is 5 centimeter. So can you write therefore the inner radius? Therefore, its inner radius equals to what? Can you please tell me? What will be inner radius? Inner radius is equal to, if it is 5 and it is x centimeter, you see it is x centimeter, okay, it is x centimeter, then we get the inner radius. Now suppose it is inner radius, only this, the inner radius, it is what? 5 minus x centimeter. So we can write down the inner radius as by 5 minus x centimeter. Now what is the inner volume? Therefore inner volume equals to, what is the formula? 4 by 3 pi 5 minus x whole cube, 4 by 3 pi a cube, right? 4 by 3 pi a cube. So 4 by 3 pi 5 minus x whole cube cubic centimeter. Please write down here in this way. Okay, 5 minus x whole cube, it has been taken to the left hand side, is equal to 5 cube minus 4 cube. Okay, that is 5 minus x whole cube is equal to, it is what? 125 minus 64, that is equal to 61, then 5 minus x is equal to, can be written, cubic root of 61. Okay. Now, from here, we can find the value of x is equal to 5 minus cubic root of 61. 1.0635. Okay, approximately, okay, that means the thickness of the hollow sphere, that means we can write here we can write here the thickness of the hollow sphere is equal to 1.06535 centimeter approximately. Okay, now we are going to question number 16. Read the question, please. Okay, now question number 16 about similar math. I mean, they are similar math. Okay, you see, it is written here. The outer diameter of a hollow sphere is 13 centimeter. Okay, the outer diameter of the hollow sphere is given as by 13 centimeter. What is meant by that? Suppose it is a hollow sphere, right? It is a hollow sphere. Write down. It is a hollow sphere. Okay. Now, it is the outer diameter. It is the center. Outer diameter of the hollow sphere is given as by 13 centimeter. Write down. Outer diameter given. Outer diameter. Outer diameter is equal to 13 centimeter. Therefore, we can write here outer radius. Outer radius equals to what? 13 by 2 centimeter, which is equal to 6.5 centimeter. Outer radius is 6.5 centimeter. You see, what is the outer radius here? This is the outer radius. Okay. So it is given here as by 6.5 centimeter. So can we find here outer volume? Write down. Therefore, outer volume equals to, what is the formula to determine the volume of a sphere? 4 by 3 pi a cube. Here a is 6.5 cube, cubic centimeter, cubic centimeter. It is outer volume. In this question, it is also told that the thickness of the hollow sphere, I mean the thickness of iron here, it is wholly and fully iron. You please try to understand, this is iron. Okay, this is wholly and fully iron. Okay, this is made of iron. Okay, now you see its thickness of iron. That means this part is what? I mean this length is 2 centimeter. Okay, 2 centimeter. Now can you find out the inner radius? What is the inner radius? You see, this is the inner radius. This is the inner radius. Please try to understand. This is the inner radius. So what will be the inner radius? It is 6.5. This is 2. So we will get inner radius as by 4.5 centimeter. So we have to write it. Write down. Write down here, thickness of iron is equal to 2 centimeter. Therefore, we can write down inner radius is equal to 6.5 minus 2 centimeter, that is 4.5 centimeter. This is the inner radius, okay? Now, what is inner volume? Therefore, the inner volume is equal to, we can write down here, 4 by 3 pi, 4.5 cubic centimeter. Please try to understand. So we have got the outer volume. You see, we have got the outer volume and also inner volume. Now, if I subtract the inner volume from the outer volume, then I will get the volume of the iron used in this hollow sphere, right? We will get the volume of the iron used in this hollow sphere. So, by melting this hollow sphere, we will get a new solid sphere. You understand? Now, a new solid sphere is to be made. That means this type of, it is a solid sphere. The question is that what is the radius? At first you have to find the radius, then we will find diameter. What is the diameter of this solid sphere? Very good. Its radius, okay, is equal to a centimeter. We can write radius equals to a centimeter. That means its volume equals to what? 4 by 3 pi a cube cubic centimeter. Now you see, like the previous math, the iron used in this hollow sphere, okay, actually that iron, I mean the volume of the iron here is equal to volume of the solid sphere. This iron and this iron, they are equal, I mean equal in volume, okay. So if I subtract the inner volume from the outer volume, that is, this is the inner volume and this is the outer volume, then we will get the volume of this solid sphere. That means we can write down, according to the question, 4 by 3 pi a cube, write down 4 by 3 pi a cube is equal to 4 by 3 pi 6.5 whole cube minus 4 by 3 pi 4.5 whole cube. Okay. Now you see, we can write here a cube is equal to, like the previous math, 4 by 3 pi, 4 by 3 pi, 4 by 3 pi will be cancelled. So a cube equals to 6.5 cube minus 4.5 whole cube, right? Now use the calculator to determine 6.5 cube and minus 4.5 cube. 6.5 cube minus 4.5 cube is equal to 183.5, okay? We are getting a cube is equal to 183.5. Okay, now we can find the radius of the solid sphere from here, that is A. So we can write down A is equal to root cube 183.5. A is what? A is the radius of the solid sphere. But I have to find the diameter of the solid sphere. So what is the formula of diameter? You know, twice the radius. Therefore, you can write down the diameter of the solid sphere. Write down here the you are required not to calculate here, okay? Then you will not get exact value, because after calculating what you do, you just omit some decimal digits, okay? Don't do it. Write down the diameter of the solid sphere. What is the diameter of the solid sphere? It is 2a centimeter, right? Twice the radius. So what is the value of A? We are getting the value of A, cubic root of 183.5. Then we can write down 2 into cubic root of 183.5, right? Now you use the calculator again. Its cubic root will be 2, so our answer is 11.3652 is equal to 11.3652 centimeter. It is centimeter approximately, okay?